Hello everyone, this lesson is about the Rankine cycle. Let's see how it looks like and how to calculate the main parameters from the cycle. Okay, so let's start taking a look on how a Rankine cycle looks like. It looks like this. We basically have four components. We have a turbine, we have a condenser, we have a pump, and a boiler. Okay? And this is the TS diagram for the Rankine cycle. So let's start here from point number one, the inlet of the turbine. Okay? At this point here, we can have saturated water vapor or superheated vapor. Depends on how much you increase the temperature of the water, okay? Depends on how your cycle works. So we have point number one, we pass the vapor through the turbine, and it expands in the turbine, generating electricity, okay, work. And from the outlet of the turbine, we reach point number two. At this point here, we generally have a mix of liquid water and vapor, right? And so we want now to decrease the temperature of this water. We pass it through a condenser. So we exchange heat with a cooling water or air or any other cooling liquid, okay, with a generally it's water, but it can be another fluid. And we have a heat exchange that goes out of our system. So we decrease the temperature of our water vapor at a constant pressure, okay? And we reach point number three. At this point, we need saturated liquid, or it can be a little bit, generally a little bit below this point here, so you have liquid to enter the pump, okay? And from the pump, we increase the pressure of the fluid, okay? We add work to the pump to increase the pressure, and we reach another constant pressure line, this second orange line here, okay? From here, we pass it through the boiler. The boiler will increase the temperature of the water. We can reach this point here, point A, where we have saturated liquid. We keep increasing the temperature until we go back to point number one, okay? Here or here. So, and then we close the cycle, okay? Well, this is basically how it works. In real life, we would have something like this. Okay, the Rankine cycle is actually here in the middle, the heat exchanger or the boiler, the turbine, the condenser, and the pump. Okay, we can heat, we can increase the temperature of the water using various types of technologies. Here, for example, we have solar plates, okay, to increase the temperature to evaporate the water in the heat exchanger, okay? And the same thing for the cooling water, okay? Here we have a cooling tower, but it can be other technologies also, all right? Okay, so let's start now modeling the cycle. Let's go step by step, component by component, okay? And we're going to use the first law of the thermodynamics to do it. So let's start with the turbine. If we apply the first law of thermodynamics, we have that the variation in internal energy, for this case, we are in a steady state, okay, everything is steady, we're dealing with the ideal cycle, so this variation is zero, okay? This is equal to the heat transfer from the control volume minus the work, in this case of the turbine, plus this part here, okay? This part here is related to the mass transfer in and out of the system. So you have the mass flow times the difference in enthalpy times the kinetic energy times the the potential energy. All right. Well, for the turbine, we are neglecting the heat transfer with the surroundings. Okay, so the heat transfer from the control volume, the turbine is zero. We're also neglecting the kinetic energy. There's not much difference between the inlet and outlet velocities, and neglecting the potential energy. Okay, so if we add these considerations here, we find this formula for the turbine work. Okay, it's just the mass flow times the difference in enthalpy. We could do the same for the pump, and we find almost the same expression. Okay, it's the mass and the difference of enthalpy in the outlet and inlet of the turbine, of the pump, sorry. For the pump, generally we use an approximation that's much easier to calculate in real life, because the specific volume of the water, in this case when you are increasing the pressure, it's almost constant. So we can calculate this work just using the specific volume times the difference in pressure, okay, of the outlet and inlet. We can apply this the same law for the boiler to find the heat transferred in to the water, okay, and for the condenser. So see that we only need the mass flow and the enthalpies in each state of the cycle to solve the cycle, actually. Okay? Now let's go through some of the performance parameters we have on the Rankine cycle. Okay? We have the thermal efficiency, and remember that efficiency is everything that goes out divided by everything that goes in. Okay, so it's our useful work divided by the energy that goes in. Okay, so the useful work or the net work for our system is actually the turbine minus the pump. Okay, the work of the pump divided by the energy, the heat transferred in the boiler. So we can use the formulas we've seen before in this formula here to calculate the thermal efficiency. So we basically have the differences in enthalpies for the turbine, the pump, and the boiler. All right. Another parameter that we have is the back work ratio. This is basically the pump work, okay, input divided by the turbine work output. We're just relating how much energy we spent, how much work we spent in the input, in the pump, okay, to elevate the pressure, divided by how much work we've produced in the turbine. So we can just add this to the formula, and we find another formula for the back work ratio. Okay, just the difference in enthalpy for the pump and for the turbine. And this generally in a cycle, it's around 1%. So it means from the work we produce in the turbine, 1% needs to go back in to elevate the pressure at the pump. Okay? All right. So now it's your turn to think about the cycle and everything we've discussed here. So take a look in the TS diagram again and think about what happens to the network and efficiency, okay, the thermal efficiency, when you increase and when you decrease the boiler pressure. Okay, try to remember where is the boiler in this TS diagram here, and what happens when you increase, in other words, you take this orange line here of constant pressure and elevates it, or when you decrease it. So think about what happens to the network and efficiency, and write down your answers in the comments sections.
Now that you've learned the theory, it's time to put that to practice. Check out our next videos for practical problems.